is an Ali. It is a push that goes in the worst of conditions. Hey, Ali, Kubakani Mayo. Ali and the Ali, you are the Ali, and we collectively are a voice of Ali that stands against the winds of corporate greed, government corruption, and no matter how much they try to blow us down, we only get stronger by sending our roots deeper into Papa Amawoku. I'm going to yell to you, hey Ali, Kumakani Maya, which means I am the Ali, and everyone is going to chant back.
Thank you. going to blow the pool to the Mauna in alignment with Aiti Pua.
There we go.
Woo!
Sorry.
Thank you.
get on a shooter with me. As always.
Hey, where's your compost capitalism banner? One there?
Oh, boy. the Kukia Imauna and GMO, and what else can I mark?
TMT, we are opposing the TMT on Mauna Kea. Everybody's uniting for various causes to protect our aina here in Hawaii. And awesome turnout, as you can see. Awesome, awesome. So, my ka'i to have all the kanaka come out and join with us today.
Push you like this?
Good. Imua, Imua.
Japan is violating this treaty with the Hawaiian Kingdom. Canada is violating this treaty with the Hawaiian Kingdom. France is violating this treaty with the Hawaiian Kingdom. The United States is violating this treaty with the Hawaiian Kingdom.
Any other words, Dexter?
You got to end the illegal occupation, man. You got to end the illegal occupation of Hawaii.
Yes, sir.
That's it, and we got to say it. Everyone's got to say it. End the illegal occupation of Hawaii.
Fake state is deception.
It's deception. It's indoctrination. It's denationalization. It's Americanization.
And you're being yourself here.
Hey, we're just speaking the truth, the truth, the truth, the truth.
Set you free. 4chan, dude. You are in 4chan. This is 4chan.
See all these different people from all perspectives. Yeah,
it was really great. Guys came out.
Yeah, where are you guys from?
Waianae.
Waianae. Oh yeah. Wow. How'd you guys get out here?
Drive.
Bus.
Drive. Bus. Yeah. That's easier than parking.
Yes.
But yeah, it's not the way you usually see Waikiki.
No.
This is the best way to see Waikiki if you ever come here with friends, yeah? Well, mahalo at the corner of Kapuhulu.
Kapuhulu?
Kapuhulu. At the memorial, yeah?
Their side, yeah.
Get this one too.
Yeah. There's no treaty of annexation.
And these ones, they get good brain over here. They understand the smoke.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
The fakery and the deception of the fake.
Yeah. Yeah. There is
the
deception.
Yeah. Well, yeah. We've been at convention center for the last 5 days. They told everybody in Anakila them that don't disturb their conference. But we've been there and we'll be there next week too.
What we should do is clean the land.
Exactly. But a lot of them in there are for us, but there's a lot that aren't. Astronomers.
Astronomers are for them. They want to know the next step.
I told them if we voyage, you'll never get up there.
Yeah.
We voyaged. Oh, aloha, yeah.
I mean, it's amazing. Yeah, how many are there?
Just want it to be safe and studied before it's released. That's a valid point.
Exactly. You know, it's not about shutting down all the farms. It's about just testing the soil to see if it's conducive for farming and if it's safe. That's all we want to know.
Yeah. It's pretty simple.
That's not the message that we're portraying. Yeah, we want to let them know that we're onto them.
Come on, Kaleo.
Hi, how did you guys get here? Drive? From what part of the island?
Kali.
Not bad.
Kali Valley.
But it's beautiful to see Waikiki like this. This is a kind of a development we need, more human development.
Roger that.
Not building development.
No, get too much already.
Yeah. Use the potential. This is the potential. Mahalo.
Thank you. Yeah. chicken.
For water. Okay, boy, get you some water.
One second.
Welcome Jordan. John is tuning up his guitar over there. I'd like to welcome all the other groups that came in just now. Aloha mai, aloha mai. E hui hui mai ka ko. E ka lehu lehu. E ka la hui.
Of. It is not just us, it is not just those who remember the Renaissance, it is not just those who have read about the annexation petitions, it is not just any one of those moments, it is all of us together. We are all in this together, and you are part of something much larger than what you see today. So please sing with us.
Thank you.
Osorio. Eo mahalo, mahalo. And I'd like to bring my teacher to the stage right now. She's gonna be the official MC for today. Miss Mento Mele Apana. Hailing from the wet island of Kauai. Yeah, and we also like to, before our next speakers come up, we'd like to call up to get Makau Ko, the following speaker. So Mr. Gary Hoosier.
Everybody from my hometown here in Waimako, for Council Mayor Gary Hoosier.
Aloha. It's a real pleasure and it's a real honor. There's so many issues around the state. It's something that we're fighting against, and we have been for a couple of years now, and there are many people are here today who are key to that movement. On Kauai, we took on the four largest chemical companies in the entire world. The Kauai County Council, the people of Kauai, we fought them for a year, and we won. The county of Maui. Maui took on Monsanto head-to-head, the people of Maui. Not the government, I have to speak straight with that. The government let the people of Maui down, but the people of Maui took on Monsanto. Fought them head-to-head. Monsanto spent $10 million to fight the grassroots people who spent hardly anything, and the people of Maui won against Monsanto. And the others for suing Kauai County specifically for the right to spray poisons next to schools and not tell us about it. That's what they're doing. We're in court. I'm confident that we're going to win. Maui County's in court. Hawaii County's in court. It makes me wonder, what's up with the city and county of Honolulu? We need to get in court with you against these companies. I'm confident that we will win. I'm confident that at the end of the day, the people of Hawaii County, Kauai, and Maui will win. But it's an honor to be here today, and what we're talking about is battles. We're talking about specific battles that we're all engaged in. But it's more than fighting against GMO or against telescopes or against the development. This is about fighting for Aloha Aina. That's what this is. We're all here together to fight for Aloha Aina. We will win when we come together like we've come together today. When we are all on the same page, fighting together in support of Aloha Aina, we can change the direction of our state and our counties and our communities. We can do it. And today, mark this down in your calendars. Tell your children and grandchildren about this, because today will go down in history. This march was the most incredible march, I believe, in the history of Hawaii. And give it up to all of you from all around our state who have come forward to make this happen. The work that's gone into this, I'd have to give a shout out to all the organizers, the people that put all this together, that have been working for weeks on this. Real quick, I want to say that we have to take this unity and move forward. All of us have different outlooks on government. Some of you believe that we don't need government. Some of you believe we don't want to participate in the Hawaii state government or the national government. I serve on the Kauai County Council, and I believe it takes actions at all levels, both in government and outside of government, to win. Okay, we need good people serving at the state legislature to win and to support the work that we're doing. We need good people serving at the council level. We need good people at all levels. And so that means to win at that level, and I believe that it's important. Small numbers matter. One or two people in the Kauai County Council can change the world. The same with the various county councils, the state legislature. So I'm here to ask you to help even more than you're already helping. We have to march. We have to hold signs. We have to write letters. We have to testify. And we have to run for public office. So I'm asking you to look into your neighborhoods, look into your own heart, and look to your neighbors, and find people who are willing to put themselves out to run for their county councils in your county, to run for the state legislature for the state of Hawaii, to run for every level of public office, and then stand up to help them. 2016 is right around the corner.
2016, we can take our government back. We have a tent over here. We're registering voters. If you want, you know, please register to vote and try to help us change our government. We can do this. United, we can do this. Together, we can do this. Thank you very much. Aloha. Imua. Thank you.
Mahalo.
Mahalo. Thank you so much. It's so great to see you folks. You know, I really want to begin with aloha aina. Aloha aina. Aloha aina. You know, after the overthrow, the Hawaiian people greeted one another with aloha aina. Love for the land. Love the land. You know, and what I'm here to talk to you about today is Ho'opili. And the reason I'm here to talk to you about that is because of my love for the land and your love for the land. And our love for the land is going to bring the people of Hawaii together for the new nation. Oh, I said that word, didn't I? Okay. I want to talk to you first of all about Ho'opili itself. Ho'opili is a gorgeous piece of farmland. It's, as you drive on the freeway and get out of Waipahu, headed out into the country, all of a sudden you bring out a civilization and it's open space on the upper side of the freeway, and below the freeway is Ho'opili, farmland. 1,555 acres of farmland. Now that farmland is 32% of the farmland that produces food for us on Oahu. 32% of our farmland. If we lose that, and if we lose the Koa Ridge property, that'll be 45%, almost half of the farmland that produces food for us on Oahu. Why do we need it? But don't we know that in California right now, the whole Central Valley is drying up? That's our breadbasket, and that's where the food has been coming in. But it's going, folks. There is going to be the time when we are going to have to provide for ourselves. We're going to have to have that farmland in order to survive. And we're going to need to do something about that now. Now. We're going to need to stand up. The thing that was that passed out to you, the little piece of paper, says call the governor and tell him, get behind saving the whole people. Get behind saving that farmland. That's something that you can do. You know, it's really important. Let me tell you that we all know that if you go to Home Depot, there are some plants that are in the shade, right? And there are some plants that are out in the sun. And they tell you, you can plant these in the sun, and you can plant these in the shade. Now, that tells you something about plants. Plants in the shade don't grow well in the sun. Now let's take a look at this item. Have you ever lived in Schofield, ever lived in Mililani, ever lived in Waiawa? Do you know what it's like up there? Overcast, rain. Let's come down and take a look at Ho'opili. Sunshine, no rain. Sunshine, no rain. What are we getting at here? There are things that grow in Ho'opili that do not grow up in Waiawa, on the North Shore slopes, or anywhere else, you know? They need that sunshine. You know, there were tests done on corn by Dr. Brubaker at the University of Hawaii. And he grew corn for years out in Waimanalo, and he could get two crops a year in Waimanalo. And the reason was, corn needs sun. And he grew corn on the North Shore slopes, and he could get three crops a year. Wait. Only three though. Why? Corn needs sun. And he grew corn down in the Ho'opili area, and he could get four crops a year. Now that's important. That's important. That farmland can produce tremendous amount of food for us. And as we go on, and we have rising seas, and as we go on, and because of the rising seas, they put in carbon caps, and carbon, of course, is oil, huh? And so the price of oil goes higher and higher and higher because of the carbon gas. We're not going to be able to bring in food. Because they can't bring in food, we're going to have to feed ourselves. How many people live here? 1 million people. We're going to have to feed ourselves 1 million people. Okay, feed 1 million people. We're going to need that money. The one thing that really needs to be driven home. Okay, I'll wrap this up real fast. But I did say that, what was I going to say about the farmer? 1 million people, we need to feed 1 million people, okay. What we need to know is that's the last lowland, sunny farmland on this island. Everything else is covered with what? That's the last piece, folks. And that's why we've got to hold on to it. I do want to say something about government right now. We're suffering the same thing they did at the time of the Democratic overthrow, way back in this before statehood. You know, our government is not cooperating. First, they sold out to the rich, they sold out to the developers, they sold out to the unions. As we sit here, we are so frustrated about government. Think of the possibilities with this convention coming up. We need a new government. Can we just have a democratic revolution? Why not restore the kingdom? Why not restore the kingdom? Thank you very much.
Mahalo, Dr. Fiona Lee. Mahalo for all your work down there on the west side of Oahu. By keeping all those council members accountable for their actions, mahalo me. Now I'd like to bring up soon to be Dr. Liz Soto. And he'll come here and share some pieces with all of you.
While nearshore currents gently coax the water from Mama's swollen limbs, new branches of navigators set their sights on seas far beyond Kamala and Nui. We prayed their call to Malapokomua would not fall on deaf ears, our songs unfurling their sails against an orange sky. And in this Holua, salt water and stone became blood and home. While Auntie Grace brewed medicines to restore faith in our own flesh, red ribbons sprouted from hearts across Papai Aina. While voices from Waianae to Waimea, from Kapa'a to Keaukaha proclaimed our independence without interference, Daddy stacked words and only as a wall to protect our verdict sector. While Hina held our Umekin and La'ila'i laid her head upon my shoulder, allaying all tears, Sali labored. The Kupuna fed you on their aloha. And when you were Ma'ana, Tutukualua swam you up from the depths on patterned shells back, broad as the horizon. Ea Maike Kai Mai, you were rising. And the drumming from below was slow at first. Ea. Ea. Ew. Yeah. Then quickening. Yeah. 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 And intensifying. Yeah. 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 Drawing me so far into myself that there was no self, only full. Full, but you know. And then you rising. And you rising. And you rising, and you rising, and you rising, rising until the tiniest curve of your quill or broke through the water's surface. You arrive. We arrive. Dark, brown, dripping, and ready. Oh, na punya ko, eola kawa kaniko oa kalo halaho makayole ko bubuwe.
Thank you so much for allowing me to be a part of this. It's just so amazing to see all your beautiful faces out here and be a part of that amazing march. This has been so much a part of hope. And I would actually like to take this opportunity to call on another island, the island of my childhood. So I'm going to read you a poem that I wrote about Maui. I grew up where breaching humpbacks burst water skins, their long bones a baseline for my dust-laden toes to travel. Before the sand filled with people, before bodies displaced the water, before whale watching was a thing, we walked a road to Keawatapu where ducks and chickens were fed, after weeds were pulled, after water poured on dry land. We walked a road to Kaamapapu, prayed our heads full of salt, our hands full of air, our bodies full of sand. They tell me it is different now. The ocean gives another taste, but that ultimate sip eludes me. In silhouettes of suspended limbs and lungs full of breath, ask me about Maui. And I still hover in a body below the surface where water is shadow and the sun a ripple of sound, and I am still that child waiting for light to catch me. Ask me about Maui, and I will tell you about a father building lace across the sky, growing Uala and Awa'uhi in hard pen. Ask me about Maui, and I will tell you about a mother growing tomatoes and sunflowers in a desert among brush fire and thorns. Ask me about Maui, and I will tell you about race, about lessons in whiteness, about learning in local, about the plausibility of denial in schoolyards with nunchucks and noses bleeding histories of resentment, about truck beds and oversized tires filled with the sour leftovers of the gas. Ask me about Maui, And I will tell you about the daughter's bedroom window and the mother growing pakalana so her child's preaching might always be sweet. Ask me about Maui and I will tell you about the bombs, about the shaking glass, about the spectred legends of forgotten goats split by shrapnel and a vagina cracked to her womb so only dust could fill her. Ask me about Maui, and I will ask you, have you seen the ocean hollow to a drum? Have you seen the sea a mass of atoms shaking apart? Have you seen how we strip ourselves to scaffolds? I grew up dreaming of Haleakala, of fishhooks, and nets, and maps, and fingers drawing among the ruins of ancient coral shoots. Translate yourself in your cartographer into a reader of atlases in a droplet. Discover my fear as a mountain, my love as a river's mouth. Sketch my laugh as a crag, my rage as an ocean trench, and then drink. Does this salt taste different at the back of your tongue? At the thickest piece of muscle and skin, where I still hold childhood of weeping whales and target practices. Thank you.